Here's how you can record the screen of your Midas M32 or Behringer X32 live console with your computer, your phone, your iPad, or all of them at the same time. Maybe you want to record different pages than the one you're looking at on the console. Now, I can think of two scenarios to why you would want to do that. First is maybe you do video tutorials on YouTube, like what I'm doing right now. Or second, you may be demonstrating to a group of volunteers that do live sound at your church, and you want to hook up the console to a bigger screen so they can all see what's going on and understand what you're explaining. But I was very surprised when I searched on YouTube for this specific thing and I didn't find any videos talking about it. Maybe because you shouldn't do that on this console. On more expensive consoles, you have sometimes an output for an external screen, but not on this one, of course. So regardless, I came up with an idea to do that. Now, is there someone else in the world doing this? Maybe, probably. Did anyone else do a video about it? No. So I'm gonna take credit for it. Yeah, so let's jump into the console. First thing, you're gonna go to setup and look here to see what version of the firmware your console is running. If it's 3. Whatever, anything previous to version 4, come on, I'm judging you so hard right now. Why are you so lazy? It takes like a minute or two at most to update your console, and it's day and night difference. Literally, this is dark mode. Anyway. After you update your console, you're gonna need the control app. So for the Midas, it's called the M32 edit. For the Behringer or Behringer or however it's pronounced, Behringer, it's called the X32 edit. I'll leave links to the download pages of these websites in the description below to make it easier for you to find them. Next, you're gonna grab an Ethernet cable and plug it here where it says Ethernet. And it doesn't really matter if it's Cat5 or Cat6 because this is just a control signal. We're not passing through it any audio like we do with the AS50 ports. Then you're gonna plug this also into your laptop and open the app. It's either gonna ask you at first to connect, or if it doesn't ask you, you can go to the setup and choose your mixer. And then here it says either mixer to PC or PC to mixer. This means that if you have something going on your mixer, you choose this and it will transfer everything to your computer. If you have edited the scene or whatever on your computer and you want to send that to your mixer, you're gonna choose PC to mixer. I'm gonna stay on that one for now. Connect, let it do its thing. Okay, great, but we're not done yet, because if I move a fader right here, yeah, it shows on the screen, but if I change to any other page, nothing happens. So I'm gonna go to the setup and go to GUI preferences and make sure to check selected screen follows mixer and selected channel follows mixer. Now, if I change to any other page, it will show right here, which is awesome. Now you want to record the screen, right? That's the whole reason why we're doing all this. So to do that, just Google OBS download. It's a free software for streaming and screen recording. Download it, install it, and here's how to set it up if you've never used it before.
When you open OBS for the first time, it's gonna look something like that. Now I'm recording with the camera like this, because if I screen record, I can't change the settings while this is happening. So you're gonna go to the plus icon under sources and click on display capture, hit OK. And this is my only screen. If you have many screens, you're gonna choose which one and then hit OK again. And then you're gonna go to the settings, go to video, and choose the resolution you're working in that your screen is set to. I'm at 1920 by 1080, which is HD, regular HD. If you have a 4K screen, set that. And the frame rate of your final video. If you're shooting at 24 frames, set it to 24. If you're shooting at 30 frames, do that. Next, you're gonna click apply and okay. Wow, it's so out of focus. Anyway, one more very important thing, and I've done this mistake before and it's very painful. Always, always right click on the screen, go to transform and fit to screen. Because if you change anything in OBS, like this, for example, and you close OBS, it's gonna stay like it is when you reopen it. It's not gonna reset. So if I open it right now, it stays like this. So just before you start recording, for safety, right click and transform and fit to screen. And now you can start recording.
Before I move to the phone or iPad, because it's the same process for these two, there's one more very important thing, and it is to hit the like button on this video if you're finding it useful so far, because you're learning something new. And it helps also.
Now, to connect your mobile phone or your iPad, you're gonna need a router like the regular one you use for your internet connection, the Wi-Fi, and you're gonna plug the Ethernet cable from the mixer right here. It should say LAN, nothing is written on here, but these are for the local area network. This is for the internet. Don't plug into the internet port because we're not controlling the mixer through internet. Okay, I've done this mistake before. These four are next to each other. This one is lonely at the corner. Don't use it. Or if you're using one of these older routers that run on the landline telephone cable, there's less room for error because the Ethernet cable doesn't even fit here. So the only place you can plug is right here. And this is annotated properly. It's written LAN. I don't know if you can see it. If it just focuses. Okay, here it is. And for anyone who feels triggered that I put the router on the mixer and is hearing scratching sounds, this is plastic. Plastic is softer than metal. Plastic cannot scratch metal. If I put my keys on here and I scratch it, yeah, it will scratch it. So just relax, don't worry about it. Now I'm gonna take that same Ethernet cable that's plugged into the back of the console and plug it right here in one of these ports. Then I'm gonna go to the phone and go to the internet. And I'm gonna connect it to the router, type in a password.
And whenever you're doing a live show, just make sure that your router has a password. It's not just open for anyone to connect to it. You don't wanna risk it. Now, unfortunately, for Android, there isn't an app from the company. It's only for iOS. However, there is an independent developer who made an app. It's called Mixing Station. You can get it on your Android phone. If you're running iOS, you can just go to the App Store and download the M32 or X32 app from there.
Now I'm gonna open the app, it's called Mixing Station, and connect. If it gives you this error that the IP is wrong, just go to the console, setup, network, and check this IP and fix it right here. So say no, click on the IP and type it out. Okay, and now it should connect.
Okay, now this is very cool. When I saw a digital console for the first time with motorized faders, I was like, whoa, look at this.
How cool is that? I mean, you can just grab your phone and walk away from the console and people will see faders moving on their own. That's crazy.
We still need to make the app follow the mixer like we did on the computer. Now, on Android, it's a pro version because it's an independent developer who made this app and they need to make money for the work they are doing, which is only fair. On iOS, you can do that, no problem.
It's snowing right now. Anyway, some phones have a screen recording feature built into them. Others don't, so you can just download an app, a screen recorder app. I use this one. It's free and it does the job. You can change the resolution and frame rate and audio quality. It's great. I'll link it also in the description with everything else. Unfortunately, I don't have an iPad or any Apple devices at the moment to demonstrate on, but it's the same process like we did with the phone. And if you want to hook up multiple devices to the mixer, you can do it all wirelessly like I did with the phone, or you can get an extra Ethernet cable and plug it right here next to the other one. You have four ports on this router. And yeah, if I move this fader right here, it moves on the phone, it moves on the laptop, and that's awesome. You can record all of them, you can record different screens for each one.
And the last very important step is to hit the like button. I mean, you're still watching till now, you obviously liked the video. Here are more tutorials on this console, and I also make music, not just tutorials. So here are some epic covers for you. Click on one of them, and I'll see you in the next video.